So I learned a couple things by hitting some shots at my driving range with this driving putter. One is you got to pretend that you're really hitting a putter and not some other kind of play club. Knowing that, you know you're not going to get much loft, so you're almost going to try to force loft, so maybe tee it up a little higher, try to maybe stay behind it quite a bit, get it on the upswing, because you have a very low lofted, very stiff shafted club that's not going to kick the ball up in the air that much. Comparing it to the original Tom Morris putter here, which I think could have been a driving putter as well, because it's got a very flat lie. The loft isn't much, it's only 3 or 4 degrees, but the lie is very flat. The shaft length is longer than the majority of putters, and there's a little bit more flex in this shaft than you would think in most putters as well. So I don't know what the intent was of this original putter, but anyway, that's my thoughts on the driving putter. The other thing is I tried for the first time using an asphaltum coating, which is the same coating that they use on these planes, but they do bake those on, and as you can see, not much success there. I had a lot of chipping. I think I must have hit it on the toe, I guess, pretty bad, but anyway, a lot of chipping of the finish there. I'll see, I might take off the whipping here halfway and then rework the finish, put a new finish on. The way I would do that is just use the card scraper, take off the finish, and you know, maybe it would take about a half hour to an hour to get something back on there.